Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to talk about PhotoMaker V2 once again, this time inside of ComfyUI. In my last video, I mentioned that the ComfyUI PhotoMaker only supported PhotoMaker V1, but this time we have an update. And if we go down, it tells us here, this is the update, and it tells us that support for PhotoMaker V2 has been added. And we'll need to use the two new nodes for that. So if you already have the Shiimizu ComfyUI PhotoMaker, you can start your ComfyUI, go into the manager, click on custom nodes manager. Under the filter here, change it to install, and then you can look for PhotoMaker. The ID 93 by the author Shiimizu is the one that we need for today's video. You can click on try update. If you do not have it, it will say install. So click on install. You will also need Insightface, and I've made multiple videos on Insightface. I will leave a link in the description below. Go back, click on the close icon, and make sure that you are updating your ComfyUI as well. As for the workflow, it is fairly simple. All you'll need to do is to click on the load default button. Click on OK. You're going to get the default workflow. Make sure that you're changing your checkpoint to an SDXL checkpoint. You can use the Lightning model or you can use the base model. It depends on you. I'm going to go with a Lightning SDXL model. Next, change your empty latent image resolution to something that is compatible with SDXL. I'm going with 768 by 1344. And you also need to change your K-sampler settings to match the base model that you're using. All right, so for me, these are the settings that I will be using. If you want to copy it, you can pause the video and copy these. Now next, we'll need to get rid of the positive prompt. Remove it. Then go into a blank space and double click. Search for PhotoMaker. And look for the one that says plus, PhotoMaker Loader Plus. Under the PhotoMaker model name, select the PhotoMaker V2. If you do not have the model, you did not watch my last video, then go into the Shiimizu GitHub repository, go down, and it will tell you here to download the models from Hugging Face. So in this case, you would click on V2. If you do not have V1, you can download V1 the same way. It will take you to Hugging Face page, click on files and versions, and then download the PhotoMaker v2.bin. If you're downloading the v1, it will say PhotoMaker.bin. And click on this little icon here. It will start the download. Next, go into your file manager, explorer, anything that you use to navigate your file, and then go into ComfyUI inside models and create a folder, name it PhotoMaker. Inside it, paste the models. In my case, I have both V1 and V2. Okay, so come back to your ComfyUI, refresh. You should now have the model here. Next, again, double click on an empty space and search for PhotoMaker Encode Plus. Once again, use the plus version. This is going to be the positive prompt. So conditioning output will go as the positive prompt in the K-sampler. The PhotoMaker from the PhotoMaker Loader Plus will go to PhotoMaker in the Encode Plus clip. You will get that from your load checkpoint. We are missing two things. One is the Insightface. So again, double click on an empty space, search for PhotoMaker and select PhotoMaker Insightface Loader. I'm going to leave mine as CPU, then connect it, and then the image will be just a load image node. I'm going to choose this one. In my last video, I also used this picture, so we'll get a good comparison there. Now, if you have a similar problem like mine, the image that you're trying to use does not have a square aspect ratio, and the face is not really the main focus. Right now, we can see a lot of the hair. You can use the prepare image for clip vision, or you can also use a simple crop image node and then simply crop the image. Now I've already tried this one, so I know these are the values I'll need. And now you can see I have the face as the main focus. This is ideally what you want to have when you are testing PhotoMaker. Now the image, whether you've cropped it or not, will go inside the PhotoMaker encode, and then make sure that the conditioning is going into the positive prompt for the key sampler. Now I've already done a couple of generation here just to save on time. It takes around 50 seconds for me to generate an image using PhotoMaker V2 using the Lightning 4 steps model. Okay, so let's take a look at a couple of examples. I've just arranged it. This is basically the face. It's going to an image crop, and this is exactly the same thing. Right now I'm using the Lightning model, and my prompt is saying photograph of a woman, IMG. Now, last time I mentioned this IMG is really important. You need to put it in order for PhotoMaker to work. It requires the trigger and the class word. And here's the result. So let me get the original one and you can see the result. Now, of course, there's no style that I've applied to the image. You can manually add the style by typing it here. For example, you can say looking at the viewer. You can also describe the background, the color, the type, all of that in here. Alternatively, we can also use the built-in PhotoMaker style. So double click on an empty space and search for PhotoMaker and then select apply PhotoMaker style. This one you will notice it will take a positive and a negative input and it will output positive and negative. Now, if you try to connect this positive to the case sampler, you see that it's grayed out. That's because these are text field. So it's a little bit confusing because of the naming. The case sampler uses positive and negative to say the positive conditioning. But in this case, in the apply PhotoMaker style, it's actually talking about positive text. So what we'll need to do is in the PhotoMaker encode plus, at the top where you have the title, right click and then select convert widget to input and then select convert text to input. This will give you a text here. You can take it, drag out to an empty space, let go, click on search and then select primitive. Okay, so you will get a primitive node. It should auto populate the text. If not, type in your text once again. Make sure that you have IMG in there. Now, we'll need to take this positive text, this string, and connect it to the apply PhotoMaker style positive input. Okay. Now, the output for the positive, this output will go in the text input inside the PhotoMaker encode node. So if I rearrange it, it's going to be like this. We are going to have the primitive text node here, which goes inside the apply PhotoMaker style. And then this apply PhotoMaker style will go inside the text there. If you're doing it for the negative prompt, you're going to get another field like this. So one for positive and one for negative. And then this negative will need to go inside the text encode for negative. So once again, right click on the clips text encode, go into convert widget to input, convert text to input, and then take the negative as the text. Now, finally, just make sure that your conditioning is going into the positive. So the conditioning for the PhotoMaker encode plus is going as positive inside the case sampler. All right, so I'm going to use this and try out different styles. So here's one with photographic. Let's go to number 6. This one is fantasy art. And for this one, I noticed that there is an imperfection here, as you can see in the face. And that's because of the low step count. PhotoMaker really likes high step counts, as well as the CFG plays an important role. And that's because PhotoMaker is mainly affecting the conditioning and the CFG. A higher CFG means that the model is going to follow the prompt closely, basically the conditioning closely. And a lower CFG, it means that it's going to have more variation. Now, of course, it also depends on the base model. Now, if you try using an SD 1.5 or 2.1, 2.0 model, then you will get an error. And that's basically because PhotoMaker will only work with SDXL models. Okay, so here I've done a new generation. And this one here, this is from 8 steps. I basically use a Lightning 8 steps model. And this one is just using the 4 steps model. So you can see here that for 4 steps, we got that deformity. And for 8 steps as well, it's not a perfect image, but it's getting better. And here's one with 30 steps, but because I'm using 30 step, I had to change the model as well as the CFG, the sampler, the scheduler, and so on. And this one, I would say it's too high because it even got the eye circle that you can see here. So if going to the original reference, we can see that we have a little bit of the eye circle there, and it even captured that and tried to generate that as well. Now, in these few images that I'm going to show, the generation that I'm going to show, pay attention to the input reference image. You can see that the character, the person is facing a particular direction, and pay attention to all the images that got generated. So right now I'm using fantasy art as the star, and basically the output image is facing the same direction as the input image. Now let's go to number 13 here. Okay, this one was just a fail. I wanted to show it to you because not all the generation will be perfect. So you'll need to play around with the positive prompt as well as the input image. In the original PhotoMaker repository, they mentioned that one image is good, but multiple images of the same person is better. Okay, so this is no style and a different seed, but you can see the character is facing the same direction. Next one, again, a different prompt. So this one is cinematic, but it's again facing the same direction. And you will see this for 26 here, 27, 8, 9, 30, and it keeps on going like this. Even the line art, the character is facing the same direction. It almost feels like there is a hidden control net inside PhotoMaker V2. So I'm not sure if this is just the seed that I'm testing, because I have the seed as fixed. I will have to do some more testing, but it seems that PhotoMaker V2 is able to capture more from the reference image and then apply that in the positive conditioning, which is basically influencing the final image. All right, so I hope this video was helpful in showcasing PhotoMaker V2 inside of ComfyUI. Let me know about your experience. Did you also notice that the character is always facing the same direction as the reference image, or was it just me? If you like this video, click on the like button, subscribe if you have not, and I will see you in the next one.